In this screencast, I'm going to show how to use the Mathematica program to do a nonlinear fit of data. So the idea is we're going to use some data from kinetics, where at a number of conditions, we've set the concentration of component A and component B, and then we measured the rate. And the units are not important for using the program, and so I've purposely left the units off, but obviously we would get the value of K that's consistent units depending on the orders of the reaction. But for the application, we're going to assume here everything is consistent in terms of units. So we want to use these data and determine the values of N and M, which are the orders of the reaction, respect A and B, and the value of K, the rate constant. So we're now switch over to Mathematica program and look at how we do this. We're in the Mathematica program now. And the first thing I want to do is put a comment in to label this. So I go up to the top and it says how to input data. I just want plain text. What I'm going to do is just copy into the program that I'm doing a nonlinear data fit. And what's important is the form that we input the data using Mathematica. So notice that I'm going to input the data between curly brackets, where the first number is the concentration of A, the second number the concentration of B, and the third number is the rate. So next thing I want to do is enter data. And right now I'm in the text format. I can hit the down arrow key and select Mathematica input and then copy the data. So these are the values from the table that I already showed you. And notice the format, curly brackets around each set of data and a comma separating each set of data. And then the entire data set is inside curly brackets. And then at the end is a semicolon, which is a command in Mathematica when you don't want calculations to be done yet. So next I hit return. What I'm looking for is a solution that I'm going to call solution. And the function is called nonlinear model fit. You'll notice I start typing, it shows up as a function in Mathematica. What's important are the capital letters where they're indicated here. And then all functions, we use square brackets. And then what I'm going to put inside of these brackets, I'm going to first tell it what data it's going to fit. And I happen to call it data to make life easy. So a comma. Next, I want to tell it the form that I'm trying to fit the data to. And this is going to be K times CA raised to some power N. And I can use the control 6 to create a superscript, put an N and then a right arrow. And then I'm going to do the same thing for B with, again, control 6 and call the other parameter M. So again, I put a comma and next I indicate the parameters in curly brackets that I want the nonlinear regression to find the best fits for. And those parameters are K, N, and M. Again, a comma. Next, I need to, again, inside curly brackets, indicate what my independent variables are. I'll put a comma. The first value in the curly brackets in the data corresponds to CA. That's what I'm telling. The second is CB. The third then is what I want to be K times CA to the nth and CB to the mth. And I notice that I have forgotten here that I need a multiplication sign between them. I could also use a space, but multiplication makes it clear what we're doing. And now I can add options. I'm going to just add one option, and that's the maximum number of iterations. And this is to make sure we're reaching a good fit to the data by giving enough iterations. Now, if I hit shift enter, it will do the calculation and come back with a fit. So that's all it takes, or what it's giving me is the value of 0.0411 is K, and then CA raised to essentially value of 1 and CB raised to 0.6. So this is the best fit. Now I can get more information in order to have a better idea. So one, I can get information on the confidence intervals. And so I'm going to type that in and then discuss what that is. So I typed in command. I'm going to use this solution. And I want the parameter confidence interval table. So it has to be in this format with the capitals as indicated. And the format in Mathematica is to put this in quotes. So now if I hit shift enter, of course the model gives me again. And then it gives me in the left-hand column the estimated values of K, N, and M, the standard error, and then the 95% confidence interval. So I get a much better idea of how good the fit is, how well this should represent the data, and it looks really pretty good for these data. Now we can also look at how good it is by looking at the residuals. So again, let me put in that command. Again, the formatting is important, a capital F and a capital R, square brackets, again, quote marks. If I hit shift enter, then it now gives me for each set of data that corresponds to the data in the list what the residual values are. And we can plot this out to get a little better idea of what this looks like. So a list plot is what we want here for each set of data. And the percent indicating we're using the most recent calculations, these fit residuals. And then the other commands are to make the graph look a little nicer and are not absolutely necessary. Again, if I do shift enter, I now have a plot where data set 1 is first, then 2, then 3, and so forth, and then how much the calculated value deviates from the measured value. And what we're looking for is that pluses and minuses are similar. It's not some pattern which indicates we don't have as good a fit. And then the final thing we can do is plot on a 3D plot the data points and the fit. So I've put in, I want two plots. First, I want to plot, it's a 3D plot. I'm going to plot X and Y axis are the concentrations of A and B. And I've given the range A from 0 to 7, B from 0 to 7. I'm plotting everything and I'm labeling the axes automatically. The second plot is to plot the data points. So that uses the data that's in the first line of the command. And otherwise similar in the points to make them stand out large. And I want to show these plots together. So notice I have the semicolon after the two commands for P1 and P2, and then I want to show P1 and P2 together. So shift enter. Here we have the rates on the z-axis and concentration of A and concentration of B, and then the irregular darker points correspond to the data points, and then the 3D shape is the fit. And then we can rotate this to try and get a better idea. Notice that from the side we can see these points fall very close on this graph. We also get an idea of how well they're distributed as to whether we've taken data at the correct points to get the best fit. So with a few commands in Mathematica, we can do nonlinear fit and we can get quite a bit of information about how good the fit is.